Hey YouTube, welcome back to the channel, and today we're back with another cash game video, but I do have some bad news. Is my bankroll has fallen below the spot I want for 5-10, so unfortunately I'll be playing 2-5 and 1-2 today. I know I get asked often about bankroll management, so I can kind of fill you guys in on what my rules are, and kind of pick and choose from there. So what I do for online 6-max cash games, I want at least 100 buy-ins in my poker bankroll effective with the tax situation. So when I'm winning money, I'm not actually winning the full 100%, or when I'm losing, I'm not losing the whole 100%. Basically, I just try to factor in at least 100 buy-ins to play a game. So for example, right now, I'm pretty close to 5-10. If we have a big winning day today, I could be back at 5-10 next video. But for today, we're just gonna be playing 2-5. Then also, if you're professional, I always recommend at least 6 months in a living expenses on the side as well. So the way I work with my bankroll and my savings is I basically pay myself a weekly salary, so that gets withdrawn from my bankroll as well as the wins and losses. So it gives you guys kind of an inside look of how I manage my bankroll, and let's jump in some cash games and trying to get back into 5-10. All right, opening seven suited, get two calls here. Pretty good start. We flop top trips small. Five on the turn. This is actually a bad turn card, so we're chopping the 7x we were beating before. Still want to be value betting though versus like a 5 here. Maybe a pair of 8s, pocket 8s, pocket 9s. Decide not to throw that pre. It's a little sticky. Get raised, just going to be a call. Take to the river. Ooh, wow. Okay, so we're actually beating like any of the 7s now because we have 7s and aces. So now that they have a 7, I think we're probably going to stack them here pretty easily. So it went from feeling like a terrible turn to a very good river, potentially. Checks. Trying to think if I want to get super greedy and go big. I don't think so. I think they're going to bet the 7x quite a bit. I guess we're targeting like a small range here. Yeah, I'm going to go 3/4. I actually don't necessarily hate jam here. But we go 3/4. They fold. Button opens, defend fives from the big blind, checking jack, jack two. Small size call, four turn check. That's pots. I think we're gonna call here. I don't imagine they have any value hands they're betting this big. Besides a jack, king river check. Diamonds miss. So it's like, I mean, kind of worried about like king X of diamonds, but I don't know if they value bet that three times. I mean, I guess they can. Obviously, king's full could have opened too. Bets for 85. Diamonds miss. I don't have a diamond. I'm kind of tempted to hero this one down here. It's a bit light, but I think I'm going to call. Oh, pocket queens. Wow, I got owned there. I did not think they would have that thin of a hand. Nice hand. Got me real good. Got me real good. All right, so good hand to at least like see, though. Obviously, you'd rather win the hand, but at least get some information there. Open ace jack, get three bet, blind versus blind. We're gonna flat and a flop top top here. See a bet here. Just gonna call. 10 on the turn check. Eight river. Go ahead and check. And lose pocket queens. Button open here, gonna be three betting jacks. See the four bet, I think out of position, mainly just jam here at 100 blinds effective three-handed against a reg. Get called up against queens. Really bad shape here. Queen on the flop, even worse. Need running jacks. Don't get it. We get one, but not the river. Opening six of diamonds. Get called. We're going to check to the button here. Turn six. So we turn two pair. We'll bet now. River nine. Value bet river. Get raised min. I mean, they could be doing this with worst two pair, I guess. So getting 4-1 will call, and unfortunately they do have a better two pair, so what we thought was a great turn card actually ends up costing us a bit more. Goes back to the cutoff. Flop top pair here, pretty good start. Go for a bet. Get raised, they're basically committed. They go call pre. I guess a player's stat line like this where they play so many hands. Probably just have to call off. They could maybe even do this with queen 10, queen jack, even if I wouldn't do that specifically. They can have jack 10, they can have diamonds. I have a diamond blocker though, straight blocker, which isn't great. I think we probably want to decide what to do here. This much money behind, I'm just gonna get this in, not feeling super good. I think they can have ace queen though, or they can just have the set. I mean, when they play a wide range of hands and they don't three bet much, so they went flat pre. So I, even with their three betting being only 2%, I wouldn't have expected queens in there. I was more worried about like ace queen than queens, but anyways, lose a stack there. Not feeling super great about it when we get it in, but I think that's probably the play we want to make. Auto top up not working here, so we're just going to jam in six big blinds, ace seven suited, get up against ace queen. And lose that as well. If you're ever curious on looking at like potential downswings and stuff, if you there's a site called Prime Dope, I think it's called. Anyways, if you Google Prime Dope on Google, it's a poker variance calculator. They have cash games and tournaments, and it shows how insane, like even in cash games, swings can be. Button open here, defend king eight suited. We're gonna flop top pair, backdoor flush draw. Bets two thirds will call. Four on the turn, check. Bets again, just gonna be a call here. Five river check. Seems like a pretty good run out unless they have like ace deuce of clubs or something like that, but lots of draws miss, clubs miss, queen 10 misses, queen 9, 10 9 dead gutters and stuff. So scary versus triple barrel. This player seems pretty aggressive though, so we'll definitely be calling with these draws missing. And they said pocket twos. All right, fun spot here. We got a under the gun limp. We raise kings, call 100 three bets. So normally we're not four bet jamming 100 big blinds, but because the pot's getting inflated with us raising the four big blinds and having a flatter, when we four bet, it's going to be a jam, especially we're slightly short stacked here, $25 short since the top up's not working. So pretty pure just jam here, I think, with kings. Back to Hunter here, has ace king hold. Hey, nice. All right, so nice double there, much needed. All right, Omni's queen suit to get called. We'll start small. Six turn, bet again. Oh boy. This is such a nitty fold. Oh man. So the problem is there's not even like flush draws from the house. So like what is he bluffing with? 7-8 backdoor flush draw on the flop. Does he even call that on the flop? Oh man, this is so nitty, but it's just hard to find bluffs, so we're gonna fold the turn. Sevens blinders blind here, flop bottom set. Take call. Not loving the diamond turn. I think we can still bet though. 10-9 even comes in, it's actually a really bad turn. Ooh, quads on the river. Trying to think if I want to check raise this or just bet. I'm gonna go for a block here to try and do some raises. If they have some boats or if they have like the ace of diamonds, I think all of those will raise. First block. And they just call though. Good versus quads, also squeak out some small value. So for example, there they had jack nine, no diamond. We got a pretty light call there. All right, alarm bell's already going off here with queens. So under the gun open, we three bet hijack, cut off cold four bets. This player only, they're pretty passive pre. So when they're putting in a cold four, this is scary, even if the hand is good as queens. So definitely not jamming. Trying to think if I even make some ridiculous folds here. I don't think we do yet. So we're gonna call 9-9-2, check. Bets half, we'll call one here. Three turn check. That's again. So at this point, you probably gotta make a decision with this hand. I think we'd make a ridiculously nitty fold. Maybe could even make arguments like, if you're gonna fold this, why are you calling flop as well as pre-flop? But man, unless he's exactly ace king of diamonds, against some players here, we would definitely be continuing. But I think versus this guy, we're just gonna make a huge fold with queens. I know it's absurd, but if we think his four bet range is basically just aces, kings, maybe queens, maybe ace king, there, we're not doing super well. Especially if we don't think he's blasting ace king enough. All right, so we open under the gun, hijack three bets. The guy that would hold forward us earlier, we have queens. This deep against this guy, I think we're just going to play as a flat. Obviously, this isn't as scary as the four bet situation, but check the jack 9-6 here. Bets out half, we'll call. Three turn check. Check, check, king river. Ugh. I'm going to block here to try to get some thin calls. We get raised, probably just folding. And yeah, sometimes they're gonna have a hand like ace king there. So I was mainly trying to target like the, I guess I don't even know if that player's stat line. Check folding feels weak. I want to keep the price or the pot small. So I decided to block. They're not sure it's great. All right, YouTube, that wraps up another losing session here. So we played for 5 hours at 5 and 1-2. Total of 2,166 hands at minus $1,150. Low point was minus 2,000, so we did make a bit of a comeback, but really trying to break this bad skid that we're on right now. So hope you enjoyed the video and the hands today. If you did, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you ever want to watch the live streams on Twitch, I have a link to my Twitch channel in the description below.